Hey mamas, breastfeeding provides the best nutrition for your baby, which is one of the reasons why moms are so eager to breastfeed. It's also a deeply bonding experience and one that has important short and long-term health benefits for both mama and baby. While over 80% of mamas start off breastfeeding their babies, less than half are exclusively feeding them at 3 months. And a big reason for that is because of the challenges mamas face when breastfeeding, such as clogged ducts and mastitis, that without the proper support makes it really difficult to continue breastfeeding their baby. In this video, you're going to learn how to prevent and overcome common uncomfortable challenges to help you have a better, more supported breastfeeding experience with your baby. I'm Bridget, and I'm a childbirth educator and a birth doula in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I love helping mamas feel confident that they are built to birth their babies and nourish them and to help them thrive. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. Almost 5% of breastfeeding mamas experience clogged milk ducts during their first year of breastfeeding. And left untreated, these clogged ducts can turn into painful mastitis that can make breastfeeding so unenjoyable and uncomfortable that it cuts your breastfeeding journey short. So to help keep you on that incredible journey with your baby, these tips in this video are going to help you prevent these challenges from happening in the first place, and second, help you treat them if they do come up so that you can recover quickly and return happily to breastfeeding your baby. So first of all, what are clogged ducts? To answer that, we are going to talk a little bit about the anatomy of the breast. In the breast, there are lots of tunnels that lead to little pockets or balloons, if you will, that are called ducts that breast milk will fill before moving through those little tunnels that lead to the nipple for your baby to drink and be nourished by. When your baby is first born, you've likely experienced breasts that are sore and are very full, or if your baby has slept for a longer stretch at night and you didn't wake up to pump, you likely have experienced hard and very full breasts. And this is because those pockets in your breasts are totally saturated with milk. Now, if your baby drinks the milk, that pressure and fullness goes down and you experience a lot of relief. But if your milk is not adequately expressed for one reason or another, it can lead to clogged ducts that, if left untreated, as in you don't get the milk out enough, it can potentially lead to mastitis. Mastitis is inflammation of the breast that can be caused by an obstruction of milk, an infection, or an allergy, and is most common in the first few weeks of breastfeeding and usually only affects one breast. So to prevent clogged ducts, and then by extension preventing mastitis, the first and most important thing that you can do is to nurse frequently, and if you have to miss a nursing session, try to pump instead. This frequent expression of milk helps keep those milk ducts from getting too full of milk and getting clogged. So you want to aim to nurse or pump every 2 to 3 hours or on demand from your baby. Of course, you can go over that 3 hour mark, but as you start feeling full, don't ignore that sensation. Make sure you are listening to your body and express milk when your breasts say, "I'm getting too full." The second preventative measure to take is make sure that your baby or your pump is adequately expressing milk. Sometimes babies that don't have a good latch or have tongue tie or lip tie have a difficult time expressing milk, which can lead to clogged ducts. So having a baby who can nurse effectively with a correct latch that is comfortable for you is going to help avoid getting a clogged duct. Now, if you're not sure how to get a correct latch, watch this video that I'm linking up here to help you understand how to get that perfect latch from your baby. So the same goes for pumping. You want to make sure that you are actually draining enough milk out of the breast from your pumping sessions. As with breastfeeding, you should be pumping around every 3 hours throughout the day and at least every 6 hours at night, if not more, especially at the beginning weeks. To pump effectively, you need to make sure that your pump flange is the right size so that you're comfortable and so that it's properly suctioning the nipple and the breast to draw out the breast milk. If you're still feeling full after a pumping session, and if your nipple is rubbing against the sides of the flange, like the little tunnel part, or if your areola is being pulled into the flange way too much while it's suctioning, or if you notice that your nipples are sort of like a whitish color, like the blood has been drained from under the skin, it likely means that your flange size is incorrect and you might need to size up or down. Your areola, which is this area of skin, darker skin around the nipple, should pretty much stay at the base of the flange, and it shouldn't be being pulled into the tunnel, too much into the tunnel. And if it is, your flange is likely too big and you should size down. If your nipple is rubbing against the tunnel or the like little insert right here, then it likely means that your flange is too small and you're going to want to size up. So having the right flange size is going to help draw out more breast milk and is going to help prevent you from getting a clogged duct. The third thing that you can do to prevent clogs is to change the position that your baby is nursing in. Doing various holds that I talk about in this breastfeeding video that I'm linking up here, which I actually already linked in the last tip as well, so it's clearly important, so make sure you watch it. It's going to help draw out milk out of different glands in the breast when your baby is in those different positions. So if you find yourself always doing the cross cradle hold, you could try the football hold or the lying down position to help drain more areas of your breast. The last step for prevention you can take is to avoid wearing restrictive clothing like an underwire bra or a very tight sports bra that restricts milk and blood flow through the chest area and breasts. During the early weeks of breastfeeding, when your breasts are more engorged and heavy, you're probably going to want to wear a supportive bra that's going to help keep everything a little bit more in place, but you don't want anything that's going to be too restrictive. Bras specific for nursing or pumping will provide you with that support, but avoid that uncomfortable confinement from a non-nursing bra. I've linked down below some brands that you can buy off Amazon that I've used as a nursing and pumping mama and that I've really loved, so you can click on those links and get some for yourself. And along with restriction from a tight bra, if you're pumping and you're pressing the flange too tightly against your breast, you could be blocking the passages of milk. So again, using a pumping specific bra is going to help you avoid doing that. All of these tips to avoid getting clogged ducts are, by extension, going to help prevent mastitis as well, because mastitis is a clogged milk duct that becomes infected. It's important that you know the symptoms of clogged ducts so that you can catch it quickly and tend to it so that it doesn't develop into mastitis. If you notice a hard lump or section of your breast that is tender and warm to the touch, even slightly red, and it doesn't go away after a feeding, it's likely that you have a clogged duct. It might feel slightly better after the feeding and less pronounced, and it might make you think, okay, maybe it's not a clogged duct, but if it's still there after you nurse or pump, it probably is some kind of clogged duct, and there are 5 things that you can do to help release that clog. The first thing to do is to apply a warm compress or take a warm shower. The warmth on the breast helps dilate what are called the lactiferous ducts, which are the little tunnels that I was talking about that go from the pockets or glands that are holding the milk to the nipple. So using warmth, especially warm running water, which is why showers are so great, is going to help release that clog. You can also use warm compresses as you are nursing or pumping to remove the clog or as a preventative measure as well. You can actually buy specific little discs that fit around the nipple on the breast that you can heat up or use as cold packs and are great to help with milk flow. I would apply heat onto my breasts in the beginning weeks when I would pump and noticed a huge difference when I would use compresses as opposed to when I didn't as far as milk flow. I'll link down below the compresses from Amazon that you can get, and whether you are dealing with clogged ducts or not, this is a really great product to have on you if you are breastfeeding. The second thing you can do is massage the clog. Massaging the breast is going to help with better milk flow anyway, so it will especially help if you are having an issue with a blocked duct. It's a good idea to couple the breast massage with a warm compress or while you're in the shower to make it more effective and more comfortable, honestly, and this is how you are going to massage the clog. Using both of your hands, one on top of the breast and then the other on the other side, you're going to move your fingers in a circular motion all around your breast, but specifically on the clogged duct. So you just move your fingers like this all around your breast. It's a little tricky to do on this one because it isn't anchored in place, but you're just going to move your hands in a circular motion, keeping them one on one side and the other on the other side as you're massaging. The other way to massage the breast is to gently knead it in a circular motion or towards the nipple with your fist. So you'll just take your fist and get on the clog and you'll lightly do it, lightly but firmly do it on the clog. Like I said, it's not going to be super comfortable, and you'll just kind of try to release it using a circular motion with your fist and then try to move it towards the nipple, because that is the direction that we want to try to get the clog to move. Like I said, it's not going to be the most comfortable sensation, but it can really help a lot. And if it's working, you're going to start noticing the duct decrease in size either while you're doing it or after a few times massaging it. To make it more comfortable and more effective, you can massage a teaspoon of coconut oil or any kind of carrier oil with a drop of lavender, geranium, and/or copaiba essential oil, which I will link down below in the description. These essential oils are anti-inflammatories, which can help prevent the clog from becoming more uncomfortable, and the coconut oil helps make the massage be a little bit easier on your skin, as well as that clogged duct. You want to try to avoid putting the essential oils on the nipple or doing it right before nursing your baby. Instead, massage your breasts with just the carrier oil before nursing, and then after you can add the essential oils. The third tip is to position your baby differently, which I already sort of mentioned. The direction that your baby's chin faces drains the most out of that area in your breast. So positioning them in such a way that their chin faces that blocked duct, wherever it is going to help draw out that milk better. Now, sometimes it's a little tricky if your clog is on the top of your breast and might mean that you're going to need to lay your baby on their back and then feed them while you are on your hands and knees above them with their chin facing the area of the clog. I know it's kind of awkward, but if it helps, it's going to be so worth doing it. And it also uses gravity in your favor to move that clog down and out. The fourth tip is to use a haakaa silicone pump, which I seriously recommend every single breastfeeding mama to have, and I will link it down below in the description. You'll fill the haakaa with warm water just enough so that you're able to suction it onto your breast, and then you're going to add Epsom salt into it. This trick has been so effective for so many mamas with painful clogged ducts and even mastitis, and if it doesn't work to clear the clog in the first time, you can do it up to 4 times every day until it comes out. The fifth tip I have for you is to take sunflower lecithin. Sunflower lecithin helps thin the breast milk to make it flow better. It does not increase the production of milk. So you take one with each meal, and if you're a mama who gets clogged ducts fairly often, you might want to just add sunflower lecithin into your daily routine as a preventative measure. I will link down below 2 brands that I recommend. My favorite is a legendary milk brand, but if they are out of stock right now or you don't want to wait for shipping, you can also buy the other brand off Amazon and probably get it faster if you are a Prime member. Before we keep going, if you are finding these tips helpful as you're watching this video, make sure you give this video a thumbs up so that YouTube knows to show it to other mamas like you who need this information as well. And if you have any tips that you haven't heard yet, make sure you comment them down below so that another mama can benefit from that tip as well. And the last tip that I have for you is to fill your diet with antibacterial and probiotic-rich foods. Antibacterial foods such as raw garlic, cinnamon, real cranberry juice, not concentrate, turmeric, and honey are all great ways to help prevent that clogged duct from turning into an infection and becoming mastitis because of their antibacterial properties. Probiotic-rich foods such as kimchi, kefir, yogurt, pickled veggies like cabbage or cucumbers, aka pickles, are great great sources of probiotics that enhance the good bacteria in the gut and in turn help fight or prevent infections. Most of us aren't getting all of the probiotics that we need just from our diet, which is why it's important to be taking a probiotic supplement as well. Research is actually showing us that using probiotics, specifically Lactobacillus fermentum and Lactobacillus salivarius, as a treatment for mastitis is actually more effective than using antibiotics, which is what's pretty routinely given for mastitis, but really tough on the gut as it kills both the good and the bad bacteria, which can take over 6 months to regrow, which means your immune system is more prone to sickness, and your baby also gets the antibiotic through the breast milk, which also damages their gut health. And gut health usually mirrors overall bodily health, so it's so important that you are taking care of your gut anyways and always, but especially if you have clogged ducts or mastitis. I've linked down below Ultra 30 Probiotic, which has both strains of probiotics that are important for prevention and treatment of mastitis. Now, if you have mastitis, all of these natural remedies can help relieve and even treat it, but it's important that you reach out to your care provider right away to let them know the symptoms that you're having. If that lump on your breast becomes increasingly red and hot, if there's burning or stinging while you are nursing your baby, accompanied by flu-like symptoms such as a fever, chills, and body aches, then it's likely that you have mastitis. If you don't want to take antibiotics, you can try the more natural remedies that we've talked about, but you need to do it under the guidance of your doctor. However, if you have blood or pus in your breast milk, if you notice red streaks on your breast, especially where the lump is, if you get mastitis in both breasts, or if your symptoms suddenly become worse, it's probably a good idea to begin taking antibiotics as soon as possible to resolve the issue as quickly as you can before it worsens, causing more harm. If you do take antibiotics, it's important now more than ever to be giving yourself and your baby probiotics to support a healthy gut and body. I've also linked down below an amazing probiotic that is designed specifically for babies. But hopefully, if you've caught it early enough and you use all of these tips, that clogged duct will be remedied quickly so that you can return it to your blissful breastfeeding experience again. Mama, I hope this video has been helpful to either educate you for the future or help you right now if clogged ducts or mastitis is something that you're facing now. If you are worried about having mastitis, I encourage you to reach out to your care provider right away and discuss which options are best for you. And I hope this video has given you some ideas of what those options are. So thanks for being with me in this video, and I will see you in the next one.